And so my mission was to be the ambassador of the culture. I was like, I am promoting my people to the billionth power.
A lot of people will be introduced to you at MTV Beach House.
Mm-hmm.
I was reading an article at one time that the first time you knew about MTV, you felt it was probably very white.
Mm-hmm.
I think Michael Jackson was the only person you would go and to look at is what you expressed.
Yeah.
Did you make it also a mission, not to harp on this conversation for too long, but did you also go into that role and make a mission of, I want to represent our people and I want to blacken things up a bit here?
Absolutely. Like, what people don't understand is that timing is everything. Right place, right time, a lot of things are possible, right? So initially when MTV was first created, it was mostly rock music at that time, right? So early 90s, MTV was still not really playing black music like that. Michael Jackson was the first dude who was deemed MTV friendly. And so as Michael Jackson came that way and knocked the door down that he don't get credit for, he knocked the door down, opened the door up for me. So now they were like, okay, well, we want to kind of be more diverse in our personalities. So we're going to have this kind of guy, this kind of girl, this kind of guy. Well, what kind of guy could represent black people and black culture that wasn't necessarily a rap artist, but was still relatable to the rap community and the pop? So I was the perfect blend. And so my mission was to be the ambassador of the culture. I was like, I am promoting my people to the billionth power. And when you see my book, you'll understand why I was so serious about that MTV opportunity, because I knew what it was. I knew what it meant to get H-Town video played. I knew what it meant to get Puffy's new artist on and how he was trying to blow up his new label over at Bad Boy. How important it was for Jay-Z to get on, how important for Destiny's Child to be on TRL with me. It was gonna change their life, B. So you going from an artist that could probably top out at gold, and you go on MTV, and now you can go platinum to diamond. Like, I remember when Usher was probably like 16, 17 years old, he was a kid. They was barely playing his music. Then him and JD came back with that that first, what was it, 1472? Was that the album? Usher was out of here. I think it was 1472.
Life in 1472.
Right? That was the album that I had. And Usher was gone. Just took off. The Brat, first album to go platinum, female artist, went platinum, me. TLC, 9 million albums, some crazy number. They were like the largest selling female group ever, bro. Three girls from Atlanta, bro. And that was the power of MTV. So if you had a movie, if you had an album dropping, you had to come through. And I was the guy that was sort of like the personality that people trusted. Cause cats knew Bill was gonna be real. You know, they knew I wasn't gonna jam you up and have you asking you some old idiotic stuff or whatever. And
you made a conscious decision not to do that?
Well, I made a conscious effort to do everything that was benefiting you as the artist. So when you come in, I'm gonna make Biggie look good. Me and Pac gonna laugh. Cause I want cats to see Pac laughing cause they think he just crazy. You know what I'm saying? But he not, he's an intelligent brother that just happened to shoot at people sometimes.